I called my friend Steve Austin, and he suggested we go back to the Grand Canyon, but not to the bottom. But we needed to see it from the air, because the forces are so large, they're so huge, you've got to get away, you've got to get higher in order to see it all.
What a great opportunity to see all this. No better way to see the country than by helicopter. In overview, it's just a tremendous way to see it. Boy, what an amazing thing this is to come over this edge. Wow, unbelievable. You know, Steve, it's really the first time I've got this sensation of all the excavation, so to speak, in the Grand Canyon. It makes me begin to imagine that it was just solid layers all the way across.
Yeah, you can imagine the continuity of strata through here.
When you say the continuity, you're talking about the layers that existed on this side of the canyon. They exist on the other side, but now they're gone. You're looking for the continuity between the layer here and the layer
yes.
over there. And
that the strata were once continuous across where the canyon is now. And we're looking at the Kaibab Plateau. It's a large part of the Colorado Plateau that has been arched. It makes an arch structure that bends the strata. We have a name for it. It's called the East Kaibab Monocline. It forms the barrier, the arch structure here. That's ultimately why we have the lake basin that was able to fill and then spill through the Kaibab upwarp, I believe, to form the Grand Canyon. I can see that the scum on the surface there, that's the tufa deposit.
Uh-huh.
And that's the bathtub ring of the big lake that was filled in this basin. Can you imagine a lake in this basin up at 6,100 feet elevation making that bathtub ring deposit?
So all of this in front of us, this was all covered with that lake.
We call it Hopi Lake.
And it comes up to a natural dam up here?
Yeah.
At this point you're talking about. And that's where at some point, for some reason, it breached. It just gave way, or maybe an earthquake or something?
Just overtopping of a natural earth dam can create spillway erosion. And there's no such thing as slow failure of a natural dam in spillover. When spillover erosion occurs on a natural dam, it erodes rapidly.
Where do you think this is occurring in terms of the flood?
I like to think of it as post-flood. The rock is already hardened. The monocline has already been flexed. The upwarp has occurred. The rocks are hardened. And then the overtopping and spillway erosion of the solid rock.
So this could be 100 years.
Hundreds of years after
the
floods, possibly.
How many different lakes are we talking about?
There may be three or four lakes associated with the Grand Canyon itself. So above Lee's Ferry in the Lake Powell area, Kapiritz Plateau, behind that another lake, that could fail. And my view is the lakes failed from the top down. The spillover of this Hopi Lake over the Kaibab upwarp into the next basin below it created what? Another lake below it, and that would be Turoweep Lake. The drainage basins upstream filled first, and they spilled, destroyed their dams by spillway erosion, and they drained to the west. And you created the Grand Canyon by top-down failing of dams into lowland areas. So the erosion is channeled to form a canyon. Okay, and it's a straight canyon, but yeah, it's channelized. And that is what we see. So we see erosion in channels by spillover, it looks like. And so the lake didn't take millions of years to drain. It didn't take millions of years for the Colorado River to erode the Grand Canyon.
And you know, really, Steve, I can look around and at least imagine and envision this wasn't carved out by a river. This is the kind of thing that you see when massive water just floods and it just evacuates all of that material.
And thinking about breach dams and the notching of the plateau by spillover, that is the latest geologic rage in thinking. The old way of thinking about Grand Canyon is, oh, it was eroded over millions of years. No. That's becoming unpopular among geologists. In fact, as I talk to geologists, very few geologists are defending that way of thinking. They are going to something freaky and catastrophic like overtopping of lakes.
Right.
In other words, we have the pieces of the puzzle that seem to assemble themselves. So we have an explanation. It's a hypothesis with extreme explanatory power. And it's consistent with the framework of the Bible.